us, and let your name alone be exalted. We thank you, merciful Father. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We give you all the adoration. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. God bless you. Please be seated. Let's celebrate Jesus again. Let's give the Lord a round of applause. A round of applause. A round of applause. Glory to Jesus. Once again, you are welcome to church this morning. Welcome to May. It's our month of miracles. It's my prayer you'll not be left out of what God wants to do this month of May in Jesus' mighty name. Mark 11:22. Today is Thanksgiving. Just a short exhortation, and then we go on to thank God massively. It's my prayer as you thank him, he will also smile on you in the mighty name of Jesus. This very month, you will see his faithfulness like never before in the mighty name of Jesus. This very month, that small thing in your hands will become big in the mighty name of Jesus. The same God that used 5 loaves, 2 fishes to feed a multitude, that little in your hands will become massive in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not diminish in glory. You will not diminish in relevance. You will not diminish in value in the mighty name of Jesus. The Almighty will encourage you. He will support you. And he will heal you in the mighty name of Jesus. Mark 11:22. The Bible says, so Jesus answered and said to them, have faith in God. For assuredly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, be moved and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. Therefore, I say to you, whatever thing you ask, where you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them. Therefore, I say to you, whatever thing you ask, whatever things you ask, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them. The Bible says Jesus was speaking, and he said, have faith in God. Say, if you say to a mountain, move, and you do not doubt in your heart, but believe that what you said will come to pass, he said it will surely come to pass. Say, whatever things you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive, and you shall have it. Things are material things. God knows we need material things. He knows you need a car. He knows you need a house to live in. He knows we need things. He doesn't want us to be consumed by things, but he knows we need things. Whatever thing you desire, when you pray, say, believe, and you will receive. So at the point of prayer, you have to believe. And when you believe, it says you will receive. And believing also means receiving. When you believe in your heart, you believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord, and you confess that he's Lord over all, Bible says you will be saved. So your faith in God matters. Our faith in God matters. As a matter of fact, let me read Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews 11, you can turn your Bibles there if you feel. Hebrews 11:13. The Bible says in Hebrews 11 verse 13, that this all died in faith. This all died in faith. They died believing God. Not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, were assured of them. They embraced the promises, and they confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. This Hebrews 11 is about the all of faith. I mean, there are people the Bible mentioned there, Abraham, Sarah, and so on and so forth, who by faith subdued kingdoms, obtained righteousness. By faith, they worked valiant in battle. By faith, they had their weaknesses turned to strength. By faith, they shut up the mouth of lions. I mean, they did exploits in the name of faith. But the Bible says some of them died believing God. In other words, everything they were believing for didn't manifest in their lifetime. But guess what? They left a legacy of faith. The Bible says many of them, even though they were dead, even in their death, they still speak. They were still living. Amen. It says about Abel's offering, that Abel gave an offering to God, and God was pleased. His brother Cain killed him. The Bible says even though Abel died, but by his offering, by that act of faith, he was still speaking. So faith will leave you a legacy of faith. Faith, because faith pleases God. When you have confidence in God, these guys, they died believing. But at the same time, we still talk about them today. The Bible said they couldn't see that even though the promises were far off, they saw the promises are far, but they were assured of the promises. Faith is substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. Brethren, you have to be careful. Don't allow what your eyes see determine what your heart will believe. Amen. I'm telling you, there are many things we can't see, but they are real. The Bible says, let your eyes be to the let your eyes focus on the unseen. Because the unseen are actually eternal things. There are many things we cannot see, but they are real. I mean, you are here, you turn on your phone, you are accessing everywhere through your phone. You don't know how does it happen? There are unseen rays, there are things in the atmosphere. So it's not everything that we see. Don't live your life just based on what you see. Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 8, the righteous will live by faith, not by sight. Say these people here, they embrace the promises, they welcome the promises, they held on to the promises, they romanticize the God's promises. The Bible says through Peter that God's promises are great and they are effectual promises. Every man's word is as good as his bond. Is that correct? Amen. Your word is as good as you. Amen. If you lack integrity, that means your word lacks integrity. If your word, we evaluate you by your words. So if your word is not good, that means you are not a man of integrity. So if you cannot stake your life on God's word, that means it's not a God of integrity. And faith is based on God's word. These people died believing. They died believing. The Bible says he knew that at some point in time, these guys were going to be slaves in Israel. And he told them ahead of time that when I die, just make sure you take my corpse with you to wherever you are going to. He said, don't bury me here. You know, because somehow they were assured. When you become assured, God is pleased. And the assurance comes in your heart. You believe God with your heart. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Many of us take our words lightly. Many of us believe, well, it doesn't matter what I say. But the Bible says the power of life and death is in the power of the tongue. The Bible says the words that we see were formed by the word of God. Everything you see were formed by the word of God. It now went on to say that the things that we see were created from the invisible. Hebrews 11, verse 3. One of the ways man is made in God's image is that man is a speaking spirit. He can speak things to be. He can speak to mountains. He can speak to wind. Jesus was speaking to the wind, and they were obeying him. He was speaking to mountain, and they were obeying him. He was speaking to the dead, and the dead was coming back to life. He was speaking to storms, and the storm was coming down. He said, that is who you are. I said, if you say to this mountain of impossibility, he said, if you tell this mountain, move, and you do not doubt in your heart, but believe, he said, it shall be done. The Bible also says Abraham came to a point of full persuasion that what God has promised, God will deliver. He was persuaded. How do you come to that point of full persuasion? Is by feeding your soul, feeding your spirit. The Bible, the scriptures, they are food for the soul of man. What you focus on magnifies. If you focus on the storm, you will drown. If you focus on the author and finisher of your faith, you will float. It happened to Peter. He was looking at Jesus. But the moment he took his eyes off Jesus to begin to look at the waves, he began to go down. What are you focusing on? Amen? You don't have money? Oh, yes. It will supply all your needs according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. When you don't have money, that's the time to even give. Give, it shall be given to you. Good measure, praise and shaking together. Oh, yes. You are sick in your body. Embrace the promise of God that by his stripes, you are healed. Jesus' body was ripped apart on the cross. Amen? He didn't need to go to the cross before killing him. I've told you that here before. They didn't even need to flog him and tear his body apart before they kill him. They could have just gone and hung him on the cross. But his body was ripped apart so that your body might be mended. People are still receiving miracle healing. I'm hearing it every time. But you know, in America, we are so sophisticated because we have everything at our beck and call. I'm hearing cancer. I mean, if you tune into Holy Ghost service on Friday, every first Friday of every month, this church holds a big, massive outdoor program every first Friday, lccg.org. That's our general verse is always there. You will hear testimonies. You will think they are lying. I'm telling you. You will hear people testify, and you will think it's a joke. One of the women said, that the general verse laid hands on her. She was crippled. She was on the wheelchair. that, of course, anytime she's coming, they will bring her down from the wheelchair, from the car, they will take her up again. That they were, so after the program, she was still on the wheelchair, and they were taking her to the car. As they were about to lift her up, somehow Alex just, she just sprang, and she walked there. So you hear these things, you say, what's going on here? Is he a fable? But it's not fable. God is still in the miracle, is still in the business of working miracles. But too much analysis paralyzes faith. When you are too analytical, God is not reasonable. There's nothing logical about God. Yes, we thank God for your brain. Your brain is sharp. But there are some issues of life you can't use with your mind solve. There are some challenges your knowing how to do it, your know-how. Amen? Cannot solve some challenges. Only God, only faith in God. They embrace the word of God. They romanticize, they believe, they welcomed it. I mean, we declare this month is a month of miracles. Some people just say, oh, it's just a cliche. A man of faith will hold on to that. The Father, your son said, is a motto. I claim my miracle. You begin to trust God that something must happen. When you hold on tenaciously to God's promises, it will always show up. There's a way you commit God to act. There's a way you can commit God. Faith commits God to act. He commits him to show up. That woman touched the hem of his garment. She kept on saying in her heart, if I can just touch him, I will be made. She kept on saying. And by the time she touched, other people were there thronging Jesus. They were all together. But this woman touched. It was a touch of faith. The Bible says God calls things that be not as though they were. The language of faith doesn't call things that be. It calls what he wants to see. That's what he calls it to be. God saw darkness, voidity. He said, let there be light. That's who you are. That's who you are. So we first believe, we become persuaded, and then we speak. We speak. Many years back here, a young man, I was sharing along these lines, a young man left church. He was believing God for internship. The thing wasn't coming through. The time was going. And he went home, he locked his door, and began to confess. Began to call the internship. That same week, he got an internship because he exercised faith. If your life is just ruled by what you see, what you hear, by your senses, you are to be pitied. There's no difference between you and an unbeliever because they live by their senses. You tell them, oh, you can be healed even when pain is racking your body. It doesn't make sense to them. But the man of faith, even when faith is racking his body, he say, look, I'm healed. In Jesus' name, Jesus bore my sicknesses. He carried my sorrows. I would rather trust in God. I would rather believe his report. When you start thinking that way, talking that way, something happens. Yes, as a young man, I was buffeted with temptations. I'll keep telling myself I'm God's righteousness. I'm not under the domain of sin. I'm not under the domain of grace. Grace will see me through. I'm above this. I will not fall. I will remain a Christian. I will remain strong in my faith. God is my helper. God is my backer. God is watching out for me. I will not stumble. Even when I stumble, I will. That's how people of faith talk. And if you keep doing that way, you will see results because God is too faithful to fail. The man to be pitied is the person we have Christians who contract prayers all over the place. If you have been contracting prayer for 5 years, is that not enough? Is that time for you to begin to make things happen? Okay, now you have been, what has your faith produced? You've been a Christian now for 10 years. What can you say your faith has produced? What results have you brought from heaven to down to earth? What have you? You want to keep contracting prayers? The person that is praying for you, he has his own problems. So when he goes to God, he first of all remembers himself before he remembers you. Some people even pay to have people pray for them. They will not give offering in church, but they will be paying prophets in Africa. And when they give back, this pastor here that will then come and nurse them. When they're in hospital, this pastor here, that will visit them. But they will not. They will be paying, busy paying prophets. 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 So many of them. 8 years ago, I was about to bury my mom. And my older sister said, one prophet in Africa said, we should pray so that we will not meet trouble at home, blah, 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 blah. I said, please go tell the prophet I'm a pastor. I mean, if four of you are going to Africa, you all live abroad, you are going to Africa, of course you should pray and fast. And by the time he got there, saw the prophet said, when he expected us to send money, we didn't send money. So by the time we got there, he said, Pastor, you see, this is my motorbike, my motorcycle is not working well again, please. So the man was trying to, instill fear in us to extort us. So if I was a weakling, something will happen. I don't need the prophet to tell me that, look, if I'm going home to bury my mom, I should believe God. I don't need a prophet to tell me that. So they're just extorting. That's the modern day Christian. Their faith has produced nothing. They don't have time for God. All their thinking is just, is so. Let me finish. Let me just round up so that I will not, let's do Thanksgiving. Amen. But on a serious note, where you believe God, you take ownership. Where you receive something, you take it first and you hone it. God wants you to take his promises and then you hone it. You hold on to it. It doesn't matter. You hold on to it. Faith takes and it hones. And we also receive by what? By thanksgiving. One of our ministers here, a few years back, probably 1 or 2 years back, we were praying over the phone, the monthly prayer and fasting. And I said something over the phone. And they believed it. And he went ahead to now, what I said, he now wrote it out, and pasted it in his closet. So every morning he's seeing that confession that this pastor said this, I'm holding onto it. That same month, his wife who had been expecting a child for about 5-6 years got pregnant. That same month. He had something. He ran with it. He wrote it out, pasted it on his wall, and he was confessing it all day long, thanking God that God has made it happen. The Bible says Abraham became strong in faith by giving glory to God. See, against all hope, he believed again. And God counted his faith to him as righteousness. He believed God so much that God was pleased. And God said, look, I cancel all your sins. I declare your sins as righteous because he believed God. God was pleased by his believing him. What has your faith produced? You've been a Christian for how long now? You can't even, when it's headache, you just go straight to Tylenol. You can't even believe God to heal headache. So if you can't believe God to heal headache, God forbid bad thing. If something terminal occurs, what happens? Your faith has your faith healed headache? Everything is there, every little thing, medication. You are so medicated. I'm not saying, please don't get me wrong. I use drugs. Before I got married, I was believing God. I don't take drugs. By the time I married a doctor, she just rubbish up. But every time I run to, amen? When I'm feeling like I go to sleep, I wake up. I'm not totally fully medicated. Of course, I use medication. Don't get me wrong. I'm just saying, look, what has your faith produced? So whatever thing you desire, when you pray, say, believe, and you will receive it. This faith waits on God. And by waiting on God, it commits God to act. That mountain can move. And that mountain will move. In the mighty name of Jesus, I see your faith rising up. I see you thanking God for a particular thing this month. We have declared the month of miracles. What are you hanging your faith on? What are you trusting God for? What do you want God to see? What do you want to see in your life this month? You have been waiting on this thing for so long. What do you want? Can you just engage the faith gear now and just believe God? Believe God. Believe God. By faith, they wrought. The Bible says by faith, some people, they wrought righteousness. They became righteous just by believing God. They trusted God. Your words matter, and your words will do you good. In Jesus' mighty name, you will speak forth life, and every word of prophecy over your life shall come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Bible says Isaac waxed great. He went forward. He grew, became very great. I declare over you, you wax great. I say to you, you will go forward, you will grow, and you become very great. Every possibility before you is becoming a plain. Every mountain before you is becoming a plain. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Bible says even demons believe. They believe. So believing is you can believe. But in your heart, do you love God? If you don't have Jesus in your heart, you don't have the love of God in your heart. Demons believe, but they don't have the love of God in them. Unbelievers practice faith, and they get results. But that may not. But if they don't give their life to Jesus, they will not make it to heaven. Am I making sense to you? So you can have a faith that moves mountains. The Bible says if you don't have love in your heart, you're of all men, you are not better off than, am I making sense? But do you have the love of God in you? Has Jesus come into your heart? Has he circumcised your heart? Do you know what it means to have God as a lover? Do you know what it means to have God as a bishop and shepherd of your soul? When was the last time you worshiped God and you feel so enraptured by him? When was the last time you felt him so much? Is your heart panting for him? Are you truly a Christian? Or is just mouth only? But in words, I mean, the Bible says, if you love me, you keep my commandments. Are you living this Christian life by the power of God? Are you living it? Or are you just a Christian in mouth only? Can we just bow our heads in prayers? Let's just bow to God and just talk to him. Just talk to him. If you are here this morning, you want to give your heart again to Jesus, or you have backslided, you want to come back home, you want to come back to Jesus, just I would like to pray with you. You are here, you are backslided, or you are here, you are not born again, and you want Jesus to come into your heart. I would like to just say a word of prayer with you. Just raise up your hand if you want Jesus to come into your heart anew, afresh. Raise up your hand. I would like to gladly pray for you, commit you to God's hand. Our God is faithful. Our God is the lover, the bishop, and the shepherd of our souls. Our God is too faithful to fail. He's too faithful to fail. What are you trusting God for this month of miracles? A miracle will surely happen. If you receive that word as the word of God, if you embrace it, if you welcome it, if you agree with that word will produce in you. Anna just agreed. The man of God said, go. Say, your prayers are answered. She believed after waiting on God for several years. At that same month, she took him. She took him. It was just, go, your prayers are answered. And the Bible says she was no longer sad. She believed God. Do you believe God's word? God's word is too much. Bible says he exalts his word above his name. God's word is above his name. Do you believe God? That sickness in your body, he can take it away. Do you believe God? He can permanent you. He can give, he can turn your status around. He can change your status. From a non-immigrant, you can become a citizen. Do you believe that? God can make it happen. He will make it happen. As you hold on to him, as you trust him, he will open the heavens. He will make a way for you. He will make a way for you. Thank you, merciful Father. What are you believing God for this month? Begin to talk to him. Begin to talk to him. What has your faith produced? What are the works your faith has produced? It's my prayer your faith will begin to produce massive works. What are the works your faith has produced? Some people's faith has produced children. Some people's faith produced mighty things. What are the works your faith has produced? Thank you, merciful Father. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We give you all the adoration. Thank you, everlasting Father. Can you please just rise on your feet? Let's just rise together this afternoon. Let's just rise together. Yemo shekaba, apa kaba kaba. Just join hands with your brother, left or right. The Bible says, if two of you shall agree over any matter here on earth, it shall be done by our Father who is in heaven. If two shall agree over any matter, it shall be done here on earth by our Father in heaven. Just agree with your brother. That's a simple prayer. Lord, this is my brother. Whatever things he's desiring, whatever things are in his heart, uppermost in his mind, Father, this month of May, please surprise him. Surprise him. Let's join our faith. Let's join together. Let's join our faith together. Let's join together. Let's join together. Let's match our faith together. Let's believe God. Believe God for your brother. Believe God for your sister. Lord, attend to my brother. Attend to my sister. Come through for my brother. Come through for my sister. Mighty God, show my brother mercy. Show my sister mercy. Answer all our desires. Answer all our prayers. Come through for her. That mountain before her, let it become plain. That valley, oh God, exalt it. Let that desire come. Let his laughter come. Let her laughter come. Lazarus cometh in the mighty name of Jesus. Let his joy come. Let it be so, mighty Father. Let it be so, King of Kings. Let it be so, Lord of Lords. We celebrate you, mighty Father. We give you all the glory. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Father, we just thank you for this time. We bless you, Lord, for all your children here, Almighty Father. Lord, you have joined our faith this first Sunday in the month of May. And Father, we believe you for miracles, O God, to emanate for us all in this month of May. We have declared this month our month of miracles. And the Bible says you watch over your word to perform it. Let there be a performance of that word, Almighty Father. We have declared your counsel. We have declared how pleased you are when people believe in you. And Father, we have believed in you this morning, and we will keep believing in you this morning. Almighty Father, let our believing produce, Almighty Father. Let there be an outbreak of miracles, explosion of miracles, this month of May, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let long-standing issues be settled. Let long-standing issues be settled this very month of May, in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, we promise you, we shall return the glory back to you, Almighty Father. The grace to hold on to you, the grace to keep believing, the grace to keep saying. Bible says, against all hope, Abraham believed again in hope. Give us the faith of Abraham, in the mighty name of Jesus. And let us have massive and jumbo results, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. As we praise you in the next segment, let our praises be acceptable, in the mighty name of Jesus. We receive with thanksgiving. As we praise you, let there be an avalanche, a breakout of miracles over this congregation, Almighty Father. Let there be a breakout of miracles over this congregation, Almighty Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let sicknesses be healed. Let afflictions go, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let bad habits, oh God, break off us, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let yokes be destroyed, Almighty Father. Let bad habits break off us, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. Your church is marching on, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. We all are marching forward, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. We celebrate you, Lord. We bless you, King of Kings. We bless you, Lord of Lords. We appreciate you, mighty Father. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Let's shout a big hallelujah. Let's shout a big hallelujah. Let's shout a big hallelujah. Well, for the next 15 minutes, I want to encourage you. Let's just celebrate Jesus. Let's thank him. Let's rejoice. Holy Spirit works when there's an atmosphere of joy. God likes it when there's joy in the house. So we just want to appreciate him, rejoice, and praise him. And we also want to give our Thanksgiving offering 30 days. I mean, God has been gracious. He's also going to be gracious again the next 30 days. So let's just honor him with our substance. Let's give something substantial, and let's dance and rejoice. And as we, God bless the band, God bless the choir, as they help us to celebrate and to rejoice this morning in Jesus' name. So let's just prepare our Thanksgiving offering, and then we will dance and rejoice and glorify the Almighty God. Your dancing will never cease in Jesus' mighty name. Your dancing will never cease. Rejoicing will never cease from your tabernacle in the mighty name of Jesus.